what a joy it is for me to greet you and to welcome you once again to our Cornerbrook Temple virtual worship service. I trust you've had a great week, enjoying the great outdoors and spending time with family and friends while continuing to abide by the restrictions placed upon us because of COVID-19. Now, as we come aside from the busyness of life and gather to worship in this way, I trust that we would be drawn into the very presence of God and that we would reach out to Him and truly worship Him in spirit and in truth, knowing that as we do, God is waiting to minister to us, to bless us, to strengthen and encourage us. During the last 3 weeks, as we've been journeying through the Lenten season, we've been focusing on the theme, what can I gain personally because of Lent? Not what can I give up, but what can I gain? Because of Lent, we can gain freedom from fear. I am no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Secondly, we can gain contentment and fulfillment by what we give away. Thirdly, because of Lent, we gain everlasting love. Today, we'll be looking at, because of Lent, we can gain a solid foundation for our individual lives. Psalm 95, 1-2 encourages us to sing for joy to the Lord, to shout aloud to the rock of our salvation, to come before Him with thanksgiving, and to extol Him with music and song. And to begin our worship for today, Chloe and Rachel will minister to us with the beautiful song, Jesus Messiah, Name Above All Names, a reminder to all of us that Jesus is our solid foundation. Chloe and Rachel for that lovely song. Beautiful words, and I trust we've claimed it for ourselves again today. At this time, I invite you to join with me in prayer. Our gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we come to you today in the name of Jesus, our Lord and our Savior. We come not as strangers, but we are coming as your children, and you're our Father. We thank you for your faithfulness, your grace, and your mercy toward us. We are so grateful that you are the God who hears us. You are forgiving and good, always abounding in love to all who call out to you. Heavenly Father, I pray that you would bless those who need you in any way today. Draw divinely near to each one of them. Bring comfort, bring encouragement, bring peace, hope, and healing as only you can. Thank you, Lord, for our youth. These are challenging times for them. I pray that you would continue to protect them, to guard them, to watch over them, and to keep them in the hollow of your loving hands. We realize that as we look around us, that we need you more today than we ever did. Father, you are our rock, our mighty fortress. We need to daily lean against you for strength. You are a solid foundation when everything else around us seems to be so uncertain. Continue to bless our time of worship. Thank you for those who are sharing with us in song. We thank you for your anointed word, and I pray that you would bless your word. May it indeed minister to our hearts. Help us to focus our hearts and our minds upon you. Fill us with your spirit, bringing refreshing, renewal, and peace and joy to our hearts. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. At this time, Heather Flight will share the scripture reading with us. Following this, Cameron Cooper will bless us with his vocal, "How Deep the Father's Love for Us."
Today I will be reading from 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 1 to 10. Therefore, rid yourselves of all malice and all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and slander of every kind. Like newborn babies, crave pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow up in your salvation, now that you have tasted that the Lord is good. As you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans but chosen by God and precious to him, you also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For in Scripture it says, "See, I, a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame." Now to you who believe, this stone is precious. But to those who do not believe, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that causes people to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the message, which is also what they are destined for. But you are chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, you now have received mercy.
Behold the I sit upon a shoulder. Ashamed, I hear a mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath had brought me life. I know that it is finished. I will not boast in anything. No gifts, no power, no wisdom. But I will boast in Jesus Christ, His death and resurrection. Oh, why should I gain from His I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart, His wounds have paid my ransom.
Thank you, Cameron, for that awesome song. That song always humbles me to think about the depth of the Father's love for me, for you. His dying breath has brought me life. When Jesus said, "It is finished," I have the opportunity now of having a new life through Christ Jesus. Today, we've been focusing on the youth of our core by featuring some of them in our service this morning. And as I thought about that and the theme that we've been using through the past few weeks of our Lenten season, the theme, "What can I gain because of Lent and Easter?" I would like to say to our youth today, and to everyone, of course, that because of Easter, we can gain a solid foundation for our lives. In the scripture that Heather read for us earlier, 1 Peter 2:6 says, "See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame." Or to rephrase that, I guess we could really say, those who trust in him will have a solid foundation to build their lives on. Now, who is this chosen and precious stone? Right, you said it. Jesus, the Messiah. Jesus, Messiah, name above all names. God gave his only begotten son, his precious son, the chosen and precious stone, so that he might come to be the sacrifice for us. 1 Peter goes on to say, "Now to you who believe, this stone is precious." Oh, I love that thought. The stone is precious because it's my rescue from sin. It's my foundation for living. It's my opportunity to experience peace and contentment in life. That verse goes on to say, however, "But to those who do not believe, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that causes people to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall." They stumble because they disobey the message. Jesus has become the cornerstone for our foundation in life. Simply put, Christ is the cornerstone for us to build our lives on, and if we are not aligned properly with the cornerstone, we will stumble our way through life. I believe that's what Peter is saying here. I want to take those moments today and to encourage all youth and all older people alike. Let's not stumble our way through life, but let's build our lives on the solid foundation, Jesus Christ. To believe on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. To believe in the message of the cross. To believe in the death and resurrection of Jesus. To believe in that Jesus has ascended back into heaven and intercedes to the Father on our behalf every day. By believing that, we will have a solid foundation to build our lives on. Now, if you look up the definition of a cornerstone, you see that the cornerstone is the first stone set in the construction of a masonry foundation. As the first stone is laid, it becomes the reference point for all other stones laid subsequent to it. Everything, every stone in that building finds its design and purpose back to that one piece, the cornerstone. It's simple, isn't it? Jesus is the cornerstone of our lives. The first stone set before the foundation of the world. So now as we live our lives, that stone becomes the reference point for everything that we do in our lives. And as we stay aligned with the cornerstone, our life's foundation will be solid and firm. Then, as Peter said, we will be blessed. And every step that we make can have a design and a purpose fixed back to that cornerstone. The opposite is true. Peter basically said, if you lay stones just as you wish, without focusing on the cornerstone as your point of reference, your foundation would not be stable. It's a sad reality, but many people are living unstable lives today because they've rejected the cornerstone. They have not believed the message. Looking to Jesus will set you on the right track. It will provide the guidance between right and wrong. Jesus becomes the focal point through which we filter every step of the journey of our lives. I think you would agree with me that in life today, we certainly need a solid foundation because we are pulled in many different directions by our emotions, conflicting views and beliefs. When we have questions, or when we feel we are stepping in the wrong direction, I say to you today, look to the cornerstone, Jesus Christ, and ask, does this align with what Jesus, the cornerstone, would do? Also, look to the demonstration of love for you on the cross of Calvary and recognize how valuable you and I are in the eyes of God. Our scripture reading in 1 Peter 2 went on to say in verse 9, but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. Now hear this, God's special possession. You hear that? We are God's special possession. So, when you are tempted to measure your self-worth or your self-value by someone else's opinion of you, look to the cornerstone. You will see a different perspective. You're God's precious, special possession. When you are confused or frustrated in life, look to the cornerstone. He will give you direction. When you are tempted to believe, to disbelieve the love of God because you feel like you are in over your head due to circumstances beyond your control, look to the cornerstone. When the world seems to be spinning too fast and you are tempted to think that there is no grand plan or design for your life, I say to you, look to the cornerstone and He will help guide your life. Here's another thought. A house that's properly built by keeping the cornerstone in focus will withstand the storms that beat against it. Aligning our lives with Christ does not mean the absence of struggles. It does not mean the absence of storms or problems or trials in our lives. But it does mean the presence of God is within us. It does mean that we have a solid foundation. It means that we can weather the storms because Jesus is with us. Isaiah 41:13 says, "For I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and says, do not fear. I will help you." We are reminded of many people who have in the past, and thankfully there's many great examples around us today of people who are very solid, stable people because they have built their lives on Jesus. And the gates of hell will not prevail against them. No one can lay any other foundation than Christ, and those who build their lives on him will never be put to shame. That calls for a hallelujah. And may God help me and may God help you to build our lives in such a solid way that people could see that we are examples of the true love of God. 1 Corinthians 1:30 to 31 says, "It is because of him that you are in Christ Jesus, who has become for us wisdom from God, that is our righteousness, holiness, and redemption. Therefore, as it is written, let the one who boasts, boast in the Lord. Boast because of what God has done for us, not what I or you can do." I could wrap it up this way. May we boast in the fact that Jesus is our cornerstone. May we boast in the fact that the foundation who died for our sins and rose again now lives as our living, alive, active cornerstone. As our cornerstone, or as our point of reference to use as our guide for life, not only does Jesus provide wisdom for us, he now becomes our wisdom. He does not only provide righteousness for us, he becomes our righteousness. He not only provides sanctification and redemption, but he becomes our sanctification and our redemption. Jesus not only provides protection, he is our protection. Not only does he provide guidance, he is our guide. Not only does he provide healing, he is our healer. Not only does he provide comfort, he is our comforter. Or not only does he provide peace, he is our peace. Wow. Allow him to be your everything. Allow him to be the cornerstone that you guide your life by. Allow him to be the stone that directs everything that happens in your life. And by doing so, you will have a solid foundation to build your life upon. I encourage you to reflect on that thought as Noah sings for us the song, "Cornerstone. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness." Christ, our cornerstone. Christ, our foundation. May God bless you. Thank you.
sweet grace. With every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. My anchor holds within the veil. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the same.
Thank you, Noah. Wasn't that wonderful? Christ is our cornerstone. And no matter what comes to us in life, He is Lord. He is Lord of all. I trust you can say, that's my personal testimony. That's the story of my life. Christ is my cornerstone. And no matter what comes in my life, I will be able to say, He is Lord of all. If that's not your testimony, oh, I encourage you to make it yours this very day. Thank you for worshiping with us today. We pray that the Lord has blessed you and will continue to bless you through the remainder of this service as we share in another song. But before we do, I'd just like to share in a concluding prayer with you today. Lord, we thank you because you are the solid foundation. You are the precious chosen stone that was laid as the foundation of our lives that we can build our lives upon. Help us, O Lord, every day of our lives and as we focus on entering into another week. Help us, Lord, to align everything that we do, everything that we say to the cornerstone. Help us to focus on that solid cornerstone, Jesus Christ. And to build our lives, our actions, our deeds, our thoughts, our words around that cornerstone. Lord, we do pray that you will bless every person who's joined with us in worship now. Lord, we don't know what the need of every heart is, but how we praise you because you do. You know every heart, you know every life, you know every concern. And so God, we leave our people in your hands, asking that you would bless them today. Some of our people are sick. Some of our people are in hospital. Some of our people are carrying very heavy burdens. I pray that in the midst of their burdens, that they would look to the cornerstone. And there they would find comfort. They would find peace. They would find strength for the day in which they have to face. And oh Lord, I just pray that you will help all of us to always trust in you, to lean upon your strong, everlasting arms. And I pray that particularly right now for the youth of our corps. God, we thank you for each one of them. We thank you for the talent that you have given to them. We thank you for the blessing that they bring to our lives. And God, I just pray that you will strengthen them. And every day of their lives, regardless of the conflicting values and views and beliefs that would come their way, help them to always focus on the solid foundation, the cornerstone, Jesus Christ, who can be Lord of their lives and guide and direct every step that they take. Continue to bless our Corps. Lord, we pray that before long we will be able to gather back into our building for worship again. But until then, we just pray that you will keep our people safe, keep our people strong, keep our people believing in you. And Lord, if there's one who have not made you as Lord of their lives, I pray that they would do that just this very day. Lord, I pray now that your peace, your love, your grace, your blessings will surround each one of our lives. And I pray with the words of the benediction, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace this day, now, and forevermore. We trust in the cornerstone and we build our lives on him. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now to conclude our service today, Jillian will sing for us a beautiful song, "Oh, the Blood of Jesus Washes Me." Oh, the blood of Jesus shed for me. What a sacrifice that saved my life. Yes, the blood, it is my victory. And it's all because of the blood of Jesus that we can have a solid foundation for our lives. We can have a personal relationship with him and gain that foundation for our lives, whereby we will have peace, we will have strength for our lives, and we will not stumble, but we will be blessed. I pray that God might bless you this week. God bless you.
Oh. to